The first song he played was It's My Party. It was the only song we had.
By 1963, Quincy had already won 2 Grammy Awards for his jazz work when he decided to try his luck at pop music with an unknown 16-year-old singer named Lesley Gore.
I'm a little kid. I don't really have experience in a studio. I don't really have experience performing in front of people.
But Quincy was determined to make Lesley Gore a pop sensation. He carted 200 song demos over to her house, where they played each song, listening for the sound of a hit.
The first song he played was It's My Party. And we listened to the whole thing through, and I thought it was pretty good. I said, let's put that in the maybe pile. And we listened to all the other 199 songs, and it was the only song we had. It was the only maybe. It's my party, and I'll cry if I want to. Cry
if I want to. Cry if I want to. It's My Party proved to be more than a maybe, celebrating its way to number one in the summer of 63.
Nobody knows where my Johnny has gone, but Judy left the same time.
Quincy went on to guide Lesley Gore to 15 more top 20 hits, establishing his reputation as a hit-making musical mentor.
What he did was took a little kid who had a certain modicum amount of talent and made me feel so comfortable that I was able to reach down into myself and come out with something that I didn't even know I was capable of.
Quincy Jones was now 30 years old, and his own party was just getting started. Quincy was already a 2-time Grammy winner with a number one pop song under his belt when his second million-selling single with Lesley Gore went to number 2 in 1964.
You don't own me. Don't try to change me.